Welcome back to Matt's Basement Workshop.
Matt's Basement Workshop is proudly sponsored by Highland Woodworking, your dependable online resource for woodworking tools, books, and supplies. With quick delivery to all 50 states, Highland is home with the legendary wood slicer, bandsaw, resawing blade. Visit them today at highlandwoodworking.com. So let's go ahead and return to our construction. We're going to take a look at building the hutch itself. Now, in this episode, we're going to continue to cut the pieces to length. And as I said, we're going to start working on the hutch here. Now, we put the first of the sides on the table saw, and we're going to use my cross-cutting sled, which definitely needs to be rebuilt. It's a little wobbly and has seen better days. In fact, as you can see, I need to make a few adjustments since the edge doesn't line right up with the blade. But it's just a matter of popping it over a little bit and then making the cut. So we go ahead and push it through, slide it back, and we now have a nice square edge there. We're going to set this one aside. And just to speed things up, of course, as we usually do, we'll go ahead and fast forward this. And as you can see, I need to make a few adjustments here and there. And then we start to make them. And every time it comes out nice and square. Now, one thing I do have to recommend is occasionally the runners need to be redone a little bit. So, you know, it depends on the humidity and they get a little fat or not, but it worked out fine. And of course, we're going to go ahead and what I'm squaring up right now is the shelves themselves. Actually, this will be the top and bottom of the hutch. So one thing I want to take a look at here is even with the saw blade, there's still some marks on there and it's not as dead flat as it could be. In fact, what I discovered is I didn't go completely to the line, again, because my crosscut sled is a little worse for wear at the moment. So since plywood is nothing more than sheets of wood put together, there's nothing wrong with taking a hand plane to the edge and cleaning it up. And so here I'm using my jack plane, paying close attention to where that line is, checking periodically after a couple of shavings, and I'm using my finger pretty much as a fence to help guarantee that it's staying nice and square. Now, what you just saw me do is I moved from one edge to another, because if I were to continue that plane all the way through, I'd end up tearing out one edge or another. So I just go usually off into the middle or just shy of the other end and then come back and finish it the other way. And when I check out with the square, it's dead flat. It's dead square where it's supposed to be. So I was really excited about it. Now, continuing on that theme of the fact that plywood is nothing more than just numerous sheets of wood glued up together, I couldn't resist doing something like this, which is taking a handsaw to a piece of plywood. Now, some of you probably already saw this because, obviously, this, as I had mentioned in last week's video, I'm a little behind on getting these put out together because I started this project essentially in February, and it wasn't until around September that I completed it. So you'll even notice, if you pay close attention to the length of my goatee, I look very clean shaven in these original videos. But anyways, though, working with the plywood, again, this premium plywood is really, really fantastic. I think if I would have used some of the home center one, even with the sharp hand blade or handsaw, it still would have tore out. But to minimize it, even with the premium, I went ahead and just took some blue tape and wrapped it around where the blade was going to be going through. It was just one of those things that I really didn't want to mess up the plywood just in case my experiment went horribly wrong. But as we'll see in a couple minutes here, it didn't, and I was really excited about this because part of the reason I chose to do this also is not only to prove to you that it could be done, but it was late at night. In fact, it was well after midnight when I was working on this one, and I didn't want to wake up the family because I might have gotten in big trouble earlier. I was in the hot seat or something. But anyways, though, that's neither here nor there. So we're completing the cut, and we'll get a look at this in just 1 second. This is a great opportunity to just practice some handsaw techniques. But like I said, it's nothing more than just sheets of plywood. So let's go ahead and, number one, let's take a look at the end result. And here we go. We're going to go ahead and take the tape off. Man, I am a good-looking guy. Look at that concentration on my face as I'm slowly peeling away that tape. I must have been longing for the holidays. It must have been right after Christmas, and I miss ripping open gifts. So anyways, though, we take a look at it, and look at that. No tear out. I think a lot of that has to do with the blue tape. And I mean, both sides. There's a little tear out there, but nothing that a little sandpaper can't clean up. Now, the real acid test is to take the square to it. So let's go ahead and take a square and double check just to see how well my handsawing technique is. And I really wasn't able to the camera angle in there just the right way. But trust me, as you can see, I'm kind of nodding, giving you that wink that, yeah, for sure, it's there. And when I square it, oh, yeah. Yeah, you're right, Matt. You the man. You the man, buddy. And sure enough, yeah, it's a little off. Need a little touching up. But you know what? That's what we'll just turn to the hand plane once again. So anyways, let's return to power tool world. And what we need to do is to create a dado across the width of the two sides for the shelf. So what I did here is I clamped both of them together, and I'm going to make one cut, and oh, look, there it happens. I'm sure all of us have had this happen to us before. The hose to our router pops right off, leaving a huge mess spraying all over the place. But the most important thing is we got the dado done, and again, by clamping the two of them together, it helped to minimize any tear out. Now, about this time was when I coincidentally was doing a plywood dado bit for white side router bits. And I just want to show you this. When you use one that's specifically designed for plywood, look how tight that fit is. That's amazing. It worked great. And the end result was it wasn't wobbly, so it's going to hold it really, really well. So let's move on to rabbiting a top, or in the top of the shelves themselves, or the hutch itself. And look how horrible. This is another one of those examples of where Matt really should have paid more attention. I have this down at my height where it's easier for me to work on a little saw bench, and I didn't do a very good job of clamping it in place, and it was sliding all over the place. Kind of a dangerous situation. So instead, I then moved to the bench where I was able to clamp it even tighter, and this is for the top itself. The main thing is to make sure you don't wobble the router like I did right there, but having it higher up, sure, you might feel like you don't have a little bit of control, at least for a short guy like me, but it works out much safer for everybody involved because you're not chasing it all over the floor like I had done with that saw bench. So kind of showing you some of my dirty secrets of how bad I can be sometimes. So anyways, this is all the rabbits and dados that we need for the hutch. So next, let's move on to the base itself. And we need a couple of dados here. We're not going to be doing any rabbits. We just need dados for the sides. And again, learning from my mistake, I've moved to the bench. And what I need to do now is to make a dado right down the middle of the border, across the middle of the border, before I should say. So I have my router fence all set up there, my nice long one from Miles Craft, and I begin to make the cut itself. Now, I made sure that fence is going to be at the same exact length because I need to make one pass on each side, and then I have to make two passes on the middle one. So this is the middle support. I'm going to put this in place and put the hose back in, and then I'm going to flip the board over, as you can see there, clamp it back into place so that we don't have to worry again about chasing it all over the place, and it's a matter of getting the clamps in the right position. And again, because I have the fence exactly where it was before, I haven't moved it, haven't touched it, I can then go right back in, plunge the bit down, and make the pass so it's exactly lined up where it would be on the opposite side. And this is also what we're going to do for both of the exterior sides. So I don't have any footage for that portion, but one thing I do need to do is, of course, you can see right there, there's that dado that will be supporting the one shelf that you saw me cut with the middle one. This is an exterior side one, and what I'm going to do here is I'm going to make a cut for the bottom shelf because the bottom shelf is just a few inches up off the floor. So again, I reset the fence, now clamping it into position. We'll go ahead and plug the router back in, and we'll make that pass. And once I've made this pass, I'm going to keep the router fence at the length that it's set at, and then I'm going to come back, and I'm going to make the same exact passes on the other exterior side, and then I'm going to make it in the middle where I'll have to make it on one side, and then once again flip it back over and make it on the other side. So let's take that off, and there we go, we have our dados. And again, this is going to be the end project that we're working towards, so we will come back next week, and we're going to start the whole glue-up process. Like I said, we'll stretch this out over a couple of months, but as you'll see, this can go together really easily in a matter of a weekend, 2 weekends at the most. Matt's Basement Workshop has been proudly sponsored by Highland Woodworking of Atlanta. With quick delivery to all 50 states, the finest woodworking tools and supplies, including their famous wood slicer bandsaw resawing blade. Visit them today at highlandwoodworking.com.